Sensing temperature is one of the most common and easiest applications in a control system. Here we are in an IT server room, and like most server rooms, no one really comes in here all that often. So what happens if the air conditioning fails? Do you really only find out about it when servers start to overheat and fail? Even if we don't control the room temperature, it sure would be nice to monitor it. Well, in this video workshop, we'll show you how easy it is to sense the room temperature and move that data into a software application. So let's head back to the workshop and get started. Here we are back in the workshop. Now, before we start hooking things up, let's start with the big picture. What's the signal path from a high level? Well, here's a block diagram of what we're going to do. We're going to take a temperature sensor, which is an electrical signal, and we're going to convert that to digital data suitable for use in any number of software or cloud applications. Now, for this workshop, I'll be using this PAC Learning Center. It's basically a PAC system with a controller, several I/O modules, and a rack, and we use it for training here at Opto 22. This panel simulates some typical I/O signals, like a meter, potentiometer, temperature sensor, LEDs, and switches. The controller is running a control strategy that's loaded into its memory. And I'll be using PAC Control on this Windows laptop to configure the strategy and then download it to the controller. You can get your own learning center and free PAC Control software at workshop.opto22.com. Now, arguably, one of the easiest ways to sense temperature is with an integrated circuit temperature device, or ICTD. ICTDs excel at applications that require fairly accurate readings from minus 40 to plus 100 Celsius, which is perfect for our server room temperature. The ICTD sensor outputs a microamp signal that's proportional to its temperature. Who cares? Why is this important? Well, what it means is that you can get an accurate temperature reading up to 600 meters away. So you might be able to use some dark Cat5 cable that you've already got running through your building to pick up several temperature sensors from different locations. The temperature input modules come in 2, 4, or 8 channel, and they can work with different type of temperature sensors, like this ICTD thermowell sensor. Okay, now when it comes time to actually hook things up, you'll find the wiring diagram on the side of the module. And the wiring on this one's actually pretty hard to get wrong. There's only two wires. So for this two-channel Snap AICTD module, simply connect the white wire to terminal 1 and the black wire to terminal 4. Now, I'm going to add the temperature module to the I/O rack by snapping it into place. I'm going to put it in position 7 here on the end. So, that's the wiring and the module installed. So now let's go to the laptop now and configure the software. Here we are in PAC Control, and we've already got our rack configured. So now let's double click on the empty slot in position 7, and we're going to add an analog input temperature module. In this case, it's a Snap AICTD. And we're going to double click on the first point on the module to open the point configuration dialog. Now we'll give the temperature sensor a tag name, like server room temp. Now this is where the temperature sensor is giving a meaningful name for your software applications or cloud services. So make sure you choose your name accordingly. Now, click on the Debug button to download the configuration of your controller. Click Yes to save, and Yes that you've made a change, and the download process will start. Once it's done, click Run to execute the new strategy. Let's open up the Debug window by double-clicking on the point, and we can confirm that we've configured our ICTD sensor correctly by viewing the temperature in real time right here. Now at this point, we can use PAC Control to monitor the temperature value and sound an alarm if it goes out of limits, or we could just log the temperature in the controller. Using a tool like Node-RED, we could write that value to a database, either locally or in the cloud. Or we could send it to any number of cloud services like IBM Watson or Microsoft Azure. For more information about temperature sensing, check out our primer on IO Solutions for Temperature Monitoring. It's form number 1767 on our website, but you can also find a link to it on workshops.opto22.com. And there you'll also find a list of the parts that I used for this workshop. So there you go. The electrical signal from the temperature sensor has been converted to digital data. Cheers, mate.